The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show. Tax the rich, feed the poor, tell their own rich no more.
Can't have just a lopsided.
Welcome to Pod Talk, everybody. You caught us in the middle of a conversation. Well, at least I caught him.
And this is Jim, who's caught.
You know what, Jeremy? Do you know what the word coming in means? The word.
Well, she must be wet.
We gotta end this conversation.
I tried. I stopped talking. You guys kept going.
Welcome to Pod Talk, everyone. I'm Paul Daniels.
I'm Jim Bell.
And I'm Jeremy Dibbs.
All right.
Now, we're the ones smoking, me and Paul.
Yeah. Jerry's the one smoking.
I'm vaping.
Hey, can you turn up the volume just to fucking hear?
Volume of what?
The speaker, so I can hear Jeremy.
It's on.
I'm having a hard time hearing him.
Good.
Go a little louder. All right, there we are. We're in. We're
in. Deaf. As long as it doesn't feed back.
Well, are you hearing any?
Nothing.
Okay. For a story, what are we going to do? We can go with the Democratic debates, or we can go with the Elijah Cummings.
That would be a long one. Let's hit that one.
All right. Do you have any subjects you want to open up with, Jeremy?
Well, just one, and I didn't really have time to research it because I was literally reading it right before we went on the air, and that was the governor of California has signed into state law that in order for Trump to appear on the California ballot for president, he must turn over his tax returns.
Can't do it. It's he can't do that. He can't just make a law like that arbitrarily.
Well, not only is that illegal, it's unconstitutional.
Well, he's trying to use a state law to fucking influence a federal election.
Exactly. It prevents those who would, regardless of whether they live in California or not, it prevents those in the state who would vote for Trump from voting for Trump because they're not on the ballot.
And they talk about how Republicans are always trying to suppress the vote.
Right.
Yeah. And that's... Oh, God. We don't want to get into the fucking border wall, the fucking vote.
It ain't going to make a difference because he's going to lose California anyway. So what the hell's the difference? He loses by a little or lose by a lot?
Yeah, it doesn't matter, truly. Jimmy's right there. It really doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
Fuck them. Let them be able to vote. There's your governor, fucking Gary Newsom. He just suppressed your vote. Do you be black fucking Trump supporters?
I thought that was Gavin, but...
Wouldn't that be great, Jeremy? You get a whole bunch of black fucking conservatives from California to march on Newsom's office and say you're suppressing the black vote.
Oh, yeah, no shit.
Do you think that story would get any traction in the mainstream media?
Hell no. Fox News probably wouldn't even air that unless they thought for sure it would fucking garner them some ratings.
You gotta do it with your own phone and fucking send it up on YouTube and see how many hits, you know what I mean?
The people think that, you know, CNN's this big-ass fucking demon and everything else, and they are, but so is Fox.
They're all
corrupt. It's a
rage. I'm pissed at Fox because they don't ask the right questions when they start talking to these people. It's like, ask them this. And
it's a ratings war. If it was you or I sitting there in these states asking these questions, most of the people would never make it off stage. They'd be done.
Oh, yeah. Because we live in a world where you have to be quick on your with reactions and shit, especially because we tease each other so fucking horribly. You just get used to snappy comebacks and shit.
These politicians get this idea in their head that because they're politicians, they know what's better for government than we do.
Yeah.
Well, we're humans. We're all humans. We know what we want in our lives. We know how to get there. We don't need some fucking dickhead politician telling us how to do it. Oh, we're politicians, so we know how to do that better than you do, better than the lesser population. Because if you're not a politician, you're beneath us. That's the attitude they're trying to convey.
I don't even believe that. Maybe to a certain extent, this is how I think they think. Hooray for me and the fuck with you. That's what they really think. They don't think they're any better than us at doing shit.
That's great. That's a great explanation, believe it or not.
Yeah, it is.
They know they're incompetent. Incompetent people, most incompetent people know they're incompetent. Because they're told it constantly.
Right. They go from job to job telling them you're just incompetent.
You're a fucking a moron. Yeah. Fucking stand over there, let the people that know.
But wait a minute. What are you saying? I get told I'm a moron all the time. Does that mean
I'm a moron? Do you know what? In most jobs I've worked in, you always had that group of fucking people that were morons, right?
Already, you're a moron.
I'll tell you right now, where I work right now, the tree service, they're fucking really professional about safety and fucking. These guys got their fucking wits about them. I feel like safe working with them.
Somebody, in your line of work, you realize how quick somebody could lose their life.
It's the second most dangerous job in the world. Yeah. Well, in the United States, I should say. Only a fisherman's more
if
dangerous.
If you fell out of a tree, and the time it takes you to take a breath before you hit the ground, you're done.
Yeah. And climbing's not necessarily even the dangerous, most dangerous part.
It's the fall or the tree hitting you.
Really dangerous, too.
Right.
I'm the guy that's pulling the tree. We actually pull trees by hand.
Yeah, it's a chopper.
No. Cut them down, and we're pulling on the tree with a rope as it's being...
See, Jim, I told you Paul was suicidal.
Oh, yeah, to make it go to one side.
To go the way we wanted to. Right. We use shims and stuff, too. Well, you know, if we have a crane, of course, we're going to use the crane and stuff. Or what? You know, if there's an excavator on the site, we'll use the excavator to pull. But when we don't have that, it's me. I've had trees drop fucking literally right in front of me. And fucking Chris will tell me, he's like, just as long as you're not any further forward than here, I've had him come there. It feels like a fucking hurricane hitting you.
Hey, Jim, I told you, boy, suicidal.
Just wave of fucking dirt and air coming at you.
What'd you say, Jeremy?
I said, see, I told you Paul was suicidal.
Yeah, he's looking at the tree saying it's 175 feet.
Yeah, just take that one step. Like the judge. Remember the judge? The Al Pacino movie.
Yeah,
he'd eat lunch on the ledge, and he'd fly his helicopter.
Justice for all.
Yeah, he'd fly his helicopter out just over half a tank and then turn it around and fly it back.
Landed on the beach.
No, I'm not that high on fucking
Pat,
leaving
Pat
this planet.
Something the guy was there.
Fucking A. It's a living. That's why I do it. I make money. Believe me. Last thing I want to do is fucking be there. What the fuck are we talking about? Oh, California's fucking law.
Gary Newsom.
They'll never get away with it, first of all. And even, like Jimmy said, even if they do, who cares?
Yeah, exactly. He's going to lose California anyways. He ain't getting the delegates. They don't split them. And she win it takes all.
Yeah, there's only one state, I believe, that splits them, and that's Maine.
Sorry about that, fellas. I accidentally muted my mic. I'm sitting over here talking away, and my mic was fucking muted.
Was it anything good?
Apparently not.
Probably the most brilliant shit he ever said in his life.
E equals MC.
Yeah.
Square.
Nobody's there to hear it. Is it fucking stupid?
Yes, it is. So wasn't the question.
We were talking about that. This lady, we were doing a job. German lady asked me, do trees feel anything, right? And I'm like, what do you mean? She's like, well, when you're cutting them, she's like, don't they feel it? I was like, no. Of course they don't. No, they don't. It's
plants,
just a collection of cells.
No, it ain't. Plants do the same thing.
No, but it feels good to them.
Well, when you cut them down, yeah, I'm sure it does.
Well,
chop your neck off and feel good.
It reminded me of a joke from, I forget where I heard it. It was like, the lady goes to the guy, she goes, "Would you be so cavalier about cutting down trees if they screamed?" He goes, "Well, if they screamed all the time for no reason."
They do now when the wind rustles the leaves.
Good fucking
thing about it. People will sit and say stuff like, plants grow better to certain music and everything else. And that's not necessarily true. It is maybe the vibration or the different tone that might help the plant, because everything's got a certain vibration or a certain frequency that it blah 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 functions better at.
Well, I bet some of the plants I would imagine here are radio waves, are satellite waves, and they must react to that shit.
There's absolutely no. You do know that there's.
They like say
study after study, and there's absolutely no evidence that talking to your plant and playing music does anything.
I understand that. I don't buy that either. But
precisely my point. That's what I was getting at. It's the frequency and not the music.
Juice, blood, and not cash. Right,
so,
it's
so
just
do,
the different
form. Do plants feel shit?
Yeah, when you chop them down.
That I wouldn't
know. Right, they bleed sap.
All right, so...
they bleed sap.
So grass. Does grass feel anything when you step on it?
I don't know. Yeah, I'm sure it does. You're gonna break a few blades, but the rest are going to survive.
Right, but does it, even the ones that survive, are they like, ah, that fucking hurt?
No,
they
it's
don't,
not
so,
like
but
that.
But it's not like they feel pain.
No, they right? don't feel pain.
Of course they don't. They have no fucking...
nervous system, I know.
When you say something like that, though, you're defining it from a human standpoint.
I can't right now, Catherine. My friend from Ireland...
I only need a pound and a half.
No, 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 fucking no, 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 no.
He's a character. You're missing out on good radio. Let her come on.
No. Just talk for a second.
Please let her come on. You said an Irish woman.
No.
Let her come on.
With an Irish accent, a big breath air, fresh air.
No, it wouldn't be.
Yes, it would be. Paul, I would be tempted to pay for your next bag.
Do you know what I'll do? I'll tell you what. Right now, I will set it up for next week. We'll do it through the Bluetooth and everything.
Right.
But I'll set it up.
I want to hear this
woman's accent right now.
I just sent you a thing. I'm on the air. So we'll set up for next week, though. I promise, all right? Are you fucking kidding
me? Talk to her. Just even the one
time. Hold on. Shh. Hey, Catherine, I'm kind of on the radio at the moment. I'm literally on the air right now. That's all right. Hey, would you like to do the show sometime? Or would you... Do you want to do it right now? You can talk about whatever we're talking about. I mean, it's mostly American politics, but you lived here for a long time.
Talking Trump.
We're talking Trump, we're talking Elijah Cummings. Now, I know you're a fan. Be the good Irish liberal. Do you want to go on the air? We can put you on Bluetooth right now if you want to do it next. All right, hold on a second. We got to set you up on the Bluetooth. Hold on. Where's my fucking...
They boob too.
Well, but you know, we're not gonna particularly ask you questions. You just talk.
Like, it's just a conversation.
It's a conversation. That's all. You're gonna be speaking. All right. We'll try it that way. What was I gonna say? Fuck. You're gonna be speaking to my buddy Jim, and we got a guy on the computer. My friend Jeremy. He's out in Ohio right now. So, hold on. I gotta plug in.
That's gonna be good.
Alright, talk, Catherine.
Talk, man.
Catherine, talk.
That is my dog, by the way.
Catherine.
I hear somebody talking.
Yeah. Catherine.
Her.
Hello.
Hello.
Do you hear us?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Alright. We got you fed into the speaker. How's it coming out over your end?
I can hear her.
Okay, great. Yeah, so we were just talking about... Oh, by the way, everyone, This is my friend Catherine. Won't use your last name, hon. She's from Ireland. She lived here in the States for a time, and then she moved back to Ireland. Just a quick synopsis. And, yeah, Catherine, we were talking about, well, we're going to get to Donald Trump. By the way, Catherine, are you a fan of Donald Trump's?
How do I feel about him? I think he's a fucking asshole.
How do you really feel?
You just told her that you would not ask her any specific questions.
Catherine, you can't be a Billy Bob.
Boris, no, look at the other one in England too. They look the same. Boris Forever Johnson. They walk the same, they talk the same, the same duck, the same duck.
Yeah, but don't you think that...
I want to hear this woman talk in person.
Economy's great.
The economy's doing really good, Catherine.
Jobs are coming back to America.
Don't you think that's good for America? Ready,
you know what? Hey, listen. No. When you deport people and you freaking have the little kids in a cage and they take their parents away, what is up with that?
Well, you do know that. You do know that program started under Obama, right?
No.
Well, yes, it did. Absolutely did.
Oh, no, Obama, you know, Obama tried to make, illegal people, to be American.
Well, yeah, but Catherine, how many people can you do that with? 10 million?
I'm talking about Irish people. I'm talking about the Irish.
Yeah, but if you do it for one group...
This woman with 30 different accents already won me over.
Okay, I understand that completely. But it's like, you cannot take kids away from their parents and... put them pretty much in a cage and then take the parents away. That's what's been going
on. Well, you've got to think about this. If you're talking about the border and separating parents from their kids, guess what? Every time one of our adults goes to prison or separated from their kids, every time one of our military personnel goes to another country and serves in another country, they're separated from their kids. Fuck them goddamn people out the border.
They're not coming over. I'll tell you right now, they're not coming over to America. Listen. They're coming to America for a better life. They're not coming there just to sit down and do nothing.
Yeah, that's what I noticed. I've infiltrated.
It's the separation that I'm referring to. If you're talking about separating kids from their parents, it happens all the time. It's not just the border.
Right. Yeah. Right. They pay that.
And it's not like they're being held up against their will. They can leave anytime they want. They just have to go south. They can't go
north. If you're going to fight for one group being separated from their parents or from their kids, you need to fight for them all. You can't say, well, the border kids are getting separated from their parents and then not fight for the veterans and then not fight for the police and then not fight for the prisoners and then not fight. You know what I'm saying? You got to fight for them all.
Or not.
What I'm trying to say is they're trying to come to America for a better life.
But we had to fix our country to make it so people could have a better life. Let them fix their country and have a better life there.
And the big difference here
is
the big difference here is Spanish, and it's like 20% of the population is Spanish that's growing. They're literally invading us without firing a shot.
I'll tell you a story. I lived in the Bronx for a while.
They don't assimilate.
Go ahead, Catherine.
This woman's accent. I want to marry her just because of her accent.
I lived in the Bronx for a while. You guys can shut me up anytime if you want to, but I've been in the Bronx for a while. They're all Irish restaurants up there.
Mm-hmm.
And every restaurant, the Mexicans running them, but every restaurant they had in the Bronx, Irish restaurants, where most of the cooks were like Mexican or Spanish or whatever. And you know what? And they're the nicest people you'd ever meet.
I don't dislike the people. You can't assimilate millions and millions and millions of people into a population. It's a recipe for disaster.
Because they all get together and none of them learn English. You know what I mean? They have their own community and they're going to, just like the Muslims are doing. They're all separating. They're allowed to segregate, but if the whites do it, they're racist. I said, this racist thing's getting really old.
No, they're not, actually. No. I back up on that one. No, they're not.
What I say is, Let Mexico, the Mexican people fix Mexico. The Guatemalan people fix their country so they are good places to live. And when people say, oh, they can't just do that. You know, the United States, we fought off fucking a ragtag army. And we fought off the most powerful fucking power in the world, Britain. And we beat them and they left. Let them do the same in their country.
Right, exactly.
They're not going to, because like a lot of this generation...
Right, they won't stick up for their own country. They're just going to come here and, oh, we're going to make it.
No. Yeah. That's not the way it is. I mean, they want a better life for themselves. I mean, most of those people come from nothing.
I know a lot of people that, nothing. You know...
Right, and then they come up here to live on welfare because they give it to them for nothing.
No, you know what?
Right.
I have to tell you...
Just being on the welfare is a better life than where they came from.
I lived in America for 26 years, right?
Yep.
Got no support from... I'd never had any handout from anybody. I worked two jobs to support
my... Did you ask for it or try to get it?
In America.
As an immigrant, did you ask for it or try to get assistance?
And most of those people come over here, you know what? They get freaking... is lower than the American system was.
Come over here and you ask for assistance and you will get it. As a United States citizen, if you ask for assistance from the government, you won't get it. If you came over here and you asked for it, you would get it. If you come from another country and ask for assistance in ours, you are handed it to it. It is given to you. If we ask for it, we're told, it's...
I married an American citizen who never made me freaking leave
that's true.
The country.
Catherine's situation was unique because she was married to an American citizen, had children with him. He didn't do the fucking paperwork and shit.
No shit, man.
And then they got divorced before he ever did the paperwork. So she's definitely a different case. You really are, Catherine. I'll give you that. Because you were, he was married to a guy and had kids with him.
I'm not a different case. Just because I'm from Ireland doesn't mean I'm a special case.
No. What I'm saying is because you were married to an American, you should have became an American citizen.
Yeah, should have. Not by law, sure.
Carry off that, right? If you guys want to hear my story, my son couldn't even sponsor me. Because he didn't even make he didn't make enough money to sponsor me. Because he didn't, if that never happened to me, he'd have to support me. And then in that case, the support would go on the state. That would not happen.
Right, because you'd be here legally. So they're not going to help you.
No, but I'm trying to say, Patrick tried to sponsor me.
If you can't sponsor him,
you have to have
money. Make enough money.
He didn't make
enough
money.
That's probably one of the
and
rules.
Then, yeah,
somebody
talk to a lawyer. He didn't make enough money. Yeah. And then that poor kid, is devastated now.
Well, you're white. And they've got different rules between white, black, and brown.
She's white.
He brings up sponsorship. And to give an example of that,
I'm actually black.
Don't call me racist. I assume
there's a woman.
Catherine's actually Indian, of Indian descent.
There's a woman I work with.
No, Catherine's lily white.
I'm as
porcelain white.
I've got freckles on my face.
You look at Catherine, you go, Irish. Irish girl. Absolutely.
Yeah, I know. It makes me look like she's Irish.
But...
And an amazingly good cook.
To bring up a point, and she brought up a good point, actually, that there's a woman I work with who's from Mexico, and to sponsor five family members, it cost nearly $40,000.
Wow. Because she did it the right way. And that's the problem. They punish people trying to do it the right way.
Yeah, no.
Exactly.
And then the illegal people just cross the border and fuck, man, here you go, housing, food.
How can you expect anybody to be able to afford to properly follow the law if the price is kind of ridiculous?
I'm telling you right now, I know what I'm talking about. I'm not saying in your case, Catherine. I'm saying when the Spanish people cross the border, the southern border, illegally, if they get past immigration, they're given everything. And that's a fact. It's an absolute fact.
Driver's license, health care.
I didn't get a dime at all. I didn't get anything at all. How come that then?
I wish you could come back so bad, Catherine. I'd love to see you.
I got a spare bedroom.
I've got a two-bedroom.
I'm living in the trailer.
Whoever the fuck you're talking to.
No, I don't want Catherine living this close. I want her in the United States, but not this fucking close.
Yeah, Paul's my neighbor.
Yeah, Paul used to be my neighbor.
Yep, we used to be neighbors.
Right.
I worked with the Rex boyfriend.
But the thing is, what I'm trying to say is, I think they're trying to come over here for a better life. And I do not believe that you guys are saying to come over here and to get everything they want.
You do now. If you're Spanish, you do. That's the ones they fight for.
Illegal immigration refers to people who cross unknowingly into the United States. Those who cross without passing at borders.
I've been here for 26 years for crying out loud.
Right, but you came here originally legally on a work visa, and you ended up getting married.
Yeah, it was a fucking 6-month visa, and I married my husband.
And you married your husband. You should have been a citizen right there.
Two kids.
How long was you here, Pat? Was you here past your visa?
That was a fucking problem.
Oh, your visa was only 6 months, you said, Catherine?
Yeah, it was a business.
Right, so you were here basically 25 years illegal.
Absolutely.
I'm not saying that to be mean or anything. I'm not. I'm just saying we're trying to just get a perspective on this. And you raised two children. They're American citizens because the father was, right? Well, she's the only one that really got screwed because she came here legally.
Should immigrants have to follow our laws?
No, he had to sign the paperwork part, and he never did that.
That's what I'm saying. You got fucked.
Absolutely.
Oh, and by the way, Catherine, you can swear it's internet radio, not terrestrial.
What did I just do wrong?
No. I said if you want to swear, it's okay. It's internet radio.
Oh, I didn't know. You know, got a big mouth anyway. You know.
No, but I'm just letting you know it's okay to swear. There's no FCC rules.
Well, there's no filter. I just say it like it is. If you don't like it, that's too bad.
By the way, I just want to ask real quick. Was that picture you posted early, is that your dog?
That's Boston.
Is that your dog?
Yeah, that's my best friend ever.
Is that a Jack Russell?
The little Jack Russell.
I love him. A good little dog. A little high strung. Right. They can be sometimes.
Read the head of Jack Russell.
Oh, I fucking love him.
He doesn't walk me. He walks me. I don't walk him.
They're strong little things,
yeah.
They are, absolutely. But you know what? He knows where his cookies are. I said, you want a cookie? And he goes, I think, he knows where his leash is, and go pick up his leash and everything.
Isn't it amazing? She lived here in the United States. It never lost her accent. Or not.
What I find most amazing about her is her accent.
Her sister, I went and picked Catherine's sister up at the airport one time. Wow. It was like a different language, dude. She's talking to me, and I'm smiling and shaking my head a lot. And she's like, you don't understand me, do you? And I'm like, no.
Oh, it's all crazy. But any case, anyway, so what are you guys doing?
Been doing it for the last 4 years.
Am I live right now?
Yes,
you are. You're here, Catherine.
Yeah, you're in 66 different countries.
Yeah, you're being heard in 66 different countries all around the world. The troops overseas are hearing you.
Hey, any other question you want to ask me? I'll tell you it all.
How about the time, do you remember the time when you were holding the remote control to the TV and you thought it was the phone and you were trying to call your mother on the island? And the TV kept changing channels and me and David trying to figure out what the fuck was going on?
Man, you know, that was one of those days.
The look on her face when I told her, I go, what the fuck are you doing, Catherine? I'm calling me mother. I was like, you guys are making me crazy anyway. And then she promised me not to tell anyone, and I've just told people in 66 different
Didn't
countries.
Didn't you really? What's up with that, Paul?
Hey, shit happens. I've done the same thing. Not with the remote, though.
Hey, that's your initiation to the show.
Lovely. Thank you, guys.
I am so glad you guys talked me into putting her on the air. This is awesome.
Yeah, he didn't want to.
No, because I didn't want to just catch him, you know, with no warning.
Yeah, that's true.
You're doing fantastic, Gato, by the way.
Anything else I can talk about?
We were going to talk about something you would have absolutely no idea about, but we could skip that and talk about it.
I'm not stupid.
You know what? I'm kind of curious. How's the job market and stuff over in Ireland?
Well, now since Brexit came in.
Yep.
You know the thing about Brexit?
Yeah, Britain separating from
that.
The European Union.
For friggin' out loud. I guess they
How are you involved in that? Now.
I'm not involved. I don't know.
No, I mean, how's Ireland involved, I meant to say.
Because she lives in Northern Ireland.
Oh, you live in Northern Ireland.
So that's
anywhere near like...
hold on a second, Jeremy. You are still in Northern Ireland, right?
Well, it's on the border of North and South. So they're talking about now having... Number of years ago, they used to have a border. You'd have to cross... I'll tell you a story. You know, you have to cross the border, they would search your car, the British Army would search your car, and literally take everything out of your car. You're going down north. I live on the south, but on the border. And they would take everything out of your car, they would go through your car, take everything out with guns on your frickin' head, pretty much. And then, if you didn't have anything there, just leave everything there, you have to put everything back in yourself. Now, they're saying now that you're going to have another Brexit, same thing. We don't want that. Who wants to go through that again?
Yeah, but the thing is, right, Brexit should be good for Britain.
Good for Britain? What about Ireland?
Good for Britain.
Well, I mean...
Well, Britain is what? Northern Ireland? Is that what she is?
Northern Ireland? Yeah, are you in Northern Ireland?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah, that's the
British
control zone.
That's British rule, yeah.
I never understood that, actually. I never really understood.
Now they're saying they don't want to know hard Brexit, meaning there won't be a barrier there, but now they're saying, oh yeah, they're going to have somebody there checking your shit and wherever you go down. I'm like, that's fucking ridiculous.
What's this, like the Berlin Wall or something?
Kind of, but no, it's a checkpoint. Yeah, it's a checkpoint.
It's a checkpoint, and who wants that anymore?
No, I understand that because the relations in Ireland have gotten so much better over the years, you know, with the Catholics and the Protestants.
Right.
Well, I've watched
the Good Friday
Agreement. I never really understood it until I met
Catholics.
The
Good Friday Agreement was supposed to be no border. There was nothing supposed to be like that. And now here we go again.
I was working with her ex-boyfriend, right? He goes, hey, you want to come to my house for dinner? I was like, yeah, what the hell? You know, he goes, oh, you can meet my girlfriend, Catherine. She's from Ireland, right? I was like, yeah, cool. So I meet her. She asked me my name, something else. And then she asked, the third question she asked me, are you Catholic or Protestant? I go, I'm Catholic. And she just smiles. I was like, I got the right one.
That's terrible. But that's what people do, though.
That's how it is.
If I mention the name...
You know what? It's not like the same, like, over here like it used to be before I went to America. I mean, people would not hang around with Protestants.
If I mention the name Jada Franson, would you know who that was?
Catherine.
Excuse me?
Jeremy's asking you a question. Hold on. Go ahead.
If I mention the name Jada Franson, would you know who that was?
I don't understand what he's saying.
He said, what was that? Jada Franson?
Yes.
Would you recognize the name Jada Franson?
From where?
From
Belfast.
From Belfast.
Belfast.
No, I never heard of him.
Oh, okay.
Her.
What's the significance, Jeremy?
She's, well, was a, originally a British political activist, highly against, you know, Parliament and blah, blah, blah. There, I mean, there's a whole lot of shit going on over there. I just assumed that with some of the stuff that this lady was doing, considering she lives in Belfast, that maybe
you gotta remember, she was in the United States for 26 years until very recently.
Until how recently?
How long ago did you go back to Ireland, Kat?
I came home to 15.
Oh, since 2015.
She may not have enough time to know who Jada Franson was.
It's not like she was getting daily information from Ireland.
All about my husband and everything you want to do in the Ireland.
You know, not for anything. Your kids are citizens. Why can't they have a...
Because he doesn't make enough money to sponsor it.
No, the kids themselves. How old are the kids?
Patrick's 28.
Well, that's what I'm saying. They're old enough to be sponsors. They're old enough to bring their mother home.
You're not getting what I'm trying to say. You don't understand what I'm trying to say. Patrick tried to sponsor me. He didn't make enough money.
See?
Meaning, what I'm trying to say to you is, if anything ever happened to me in the States, he'd have to support me,
and they're not willing to allow
make enough money.
Yeah.
Patrick
doesn't make enough money. Her son to sponsor her to come over here, because if anything happens to her and she can't work or something, right? Then the government will be responsible for her, and they don't want
to
take on that obligation.
They're giving it to illegals,
that's what I'm saying.
This is just retarded.
The people that are trying to do it right get it shoved up their ass,
right?
And the fucking ones that just prance across
dragging
the border,
kids, not even their own,
Did you know?
No.
Hey, Catherine, did you know this little factoid? 80% of the women crossing the border get raped by either other immigrants or the coyotes bringing them across the border. 80%.
They're giving 10-year-olds
syphilis,
STD
gonorrhea.
Listen,
I probably won't get back to the States for 10 years. You know that, right?
You'll get back here, Catherine.
No. I left on my own.
I know, but you can say, can you get a passport?
But this it. I have a passport.
Then why can't you just come over on a vacation?
I don't think that he's letting me back in.
Have you tried?
You stay over. I didn't get in any trouble or anything.
No, no, that's what I'm saying. Don't like there's a warrant sitting here waiting for you. I said it's not like, you know, you step off the plane and the cops will be waiting. You have no warrant out for your arrest or nothing.
There was something on the television the other day that, like, Donald Trump says, I don't care where you are, we're going to pick you up anyway.
We're going to keep you what?
He picked up some guy who had a family in America, an Irish guy, and took him out of somewhere, I don't know where the hell he was, and deported him. You don't actually have to be deported off the bat. They put you somewhere, a detention. It could be a few months before they even freaking get you home, but he lost his whole family. And they're getting him out of the country. I'm like, is this crazy or what?
That's because they're filling up on the empty planes. They taking people across, you know what I mean? They're doing as cheap as possible.
And not to mention, Catherine, you went home voluntarily.
Yeah, that's true.
Never mind. I was going to say something really profound, but I thought about it and I knew I was about to get it jammed up my ass.
What?
No, because you didn't actually get deported. That's right. You left voluntarily.
Oh, but I know, but he's making it really difficult now, even for the Irish people. And they took this guy. I don't know where he was. He even said, Trump says, I don't care where you are, I'm going to come and get you. And he got this guy. I don't know, he was married, I guess, to an American girl or whatever. And they had family. And then they put him in deportation. And you don't go home straight off the bat. They put them in fucking jail, pretty much.
I don't get this. That's why I said, my second wife was a Colombian that came here on a visa. She blew up and never went home. She was here like 10 years when I met her. I married her. And,
well, you met her legal. I didn't ever got legal. So don't.
Well, she told me right up front and everything about it. My mother's dying. I said, yeah, I'm more than happy. Because I didn't. Well, after my. I kept telling my first wife I'd never get married again. But this one I felt bad. I even went down to Columbia. I was there for 2 weeks, met her mother. She died a week later.
She bought you a washer and dryer.
Washer.
Oh, she bought you the washer.
Yeah. She called the cops on me one night because she come home with, what's the yellow synthetic sugar? Sweet and low, and I drink Inkwell, and she knows
oh,
I
do. Oh, my.
Oh, so I tore the kitchen apart when I went up to get the sugar. It was sweet and low. I just fucking tore it apart. Emptied everything out of the room.
Find sweet and low over here, goddammit.
Thank God you're on the right meds now, Jim.
Yeah, exactly. That's when I started going seeing a psychiatrist.
We're out just so we don't run over because we got Glenn. Oh shit! We still got 15 minutes.
Thanks for reminding me to set it up.
No, no problem.
Guns are repeat.
Give me a second, Catherine? Can you give me a second? I just want to do a quick plug. Following Pot Talk, Glenn Spillman will be on. I forget the name of his show. Oh my god! I just
Sports Insider.
Sports Insider with Glenn Spillman, and it's not just sports. It's all sorts of things. Like I said, he's very knowledgeable.
Yeah, but
it's a really good show.
He is. He's definitely an insider.
Yeah,
That's why it's called Sports Insider.
Yeah, he's a pro. He knows what he's doing. He's all like
yeah, the fight is on last week or the week before, and they were talking shit over the radio, and they were just, I'm going to fucking kill you. You're on internet radio. They can say anything they want.
They can say whatever they want. And I love it. That was one of the...
Then I swore, and I didn't know I should have swear or not.
Don't worry. We don't have a dump button or nothing. Say whatever you want. I use the C word
no
occasionally.
Filter.
I won't
no
with you
filter
on.
In my mouth. That's how like it is, and that's it.
Yeah. Yeah, the owner of the station told me to calm down on the swearing a little bit because I was getting just brutal. Every other word out of my mouth.
It was the C.
Oh, oh, oh Jimmy!
That was close.
Yes,
I just about spilled
this
drink.
Oh, Jimmy almost spilled his drink. He's fucking notorious for this shit. I mean, I have to buy two different mugs.
You guys drink alcohol while you're freaking talking on the internet?
Yeah.
So where are you guys out of, anyway?
We're in Salem, New Hampshire.
Dayton, Ohio.
Yeah.
30 miles north of Boston.
Me and Jimmy are in Salem, New Hampshire. And Jeremy's... You're in Dayton?
Technically, yes.
That would I thought be you lived in Middletown or something like that.
The hell no. Who in the fuck? I think I'd rather live in...
I don't even know where you are, goddammit.
You don't know where Salem, New Hampshire is? It's right over the border.
I know where Salem... No, you...
No. There's a Salem, Mass.
I didn't know you were for a minute.
And then there's a Salem, New Hampshire.
Catherine, you lived fucking less than 20 miles from where I am right now for 20-something years.
Yeah, I know where Salem is.
Oh, okay.
Either I've done that.
Remember, tax-free Salem. Little plug for the town.
Tax-free Salem.
It is. It's tax-free, brother.
Guys.
Yeah, that is. It's nice to go in there when they tell you what it is on the, you know, the price chart or whatever, and you go there and you pay the same thing. They don't add tax, none of that. It's like great.
Nope.
But it's the same thing as over here. You go across the border.
You mean to Taxachusetts?
But you guys don't have freaking guns stacking in your face.
We have actually New Hampshire is
cops.
New Hampshire is a constitutional carry state. You don't even have to have a permit to carry a gun. I can carry a gun here, Catherine.
That's not what I meant. I mean, you can go to New Hampshire. I've been to New Hampshire with you before, Paul, and it's completely different than over here. You cross the border here, and they're trying to put the same thing back in this Brexit thing. It's going to be a cross-border thing.
I think once Brexit happens, and it's not new.
Because
the borders will go away.
Yeah, because they're going to want to trade with Ireland.
Mm.
You know what I mean? You there must be some shit you buy. Oh, you absolutely have a boycott on all that.
Oh, yeah?
You'd buy anything from England?
To me? The was English. I mean, it used to be cheaper to go down the north and buy whatever you needed. But as I said, the guns would be on your face.
Island. I would marry this woman sight unseen just because of her accent.
Okay. I'll set it up.
Oh, we can't understand what I'm saying.
All you gotta do is fly to Ireland, brother.
I can at least understand what she's saying. I'm just saying I love the fucking accent.
Hey, Jeremy's falling in love with your accent, Catherine.
You got an admirer.
How old are you, Jeremy?
45.
He's 45, Catherine.
Nah, a little older than that, my little friend.
Mm-hmm. He's got a nice car.
My little friend.
Nah, I don't give a shit about the car.
Left when it's running.
It doesn't matter if it's running or not. I'm not going to pay to ship it to Ireland.
I know, what's that love?
You know what? My boss...
Believe it or not, I've been planning for years to go to Ireland.
When Trump got elected... He bought a huge log processor. This thing was expensive, at least $100,000, right? And a brand new bucket truck that I know cost $140,000. Boom. Done. He was so confident when Trump got elected that business was going to boom. Right. And guess what?
It did.
In one day, he spent...
Like I said, half the country is brain dead, and that's the kids that bring it up.
He spent two.
That's all they got is young kids and old Democrats that won't change.
Jimmy, this guy, right. We're not a big company. He spent $250,000 in 1 week. He was that confident.
Right.
That could have bankrupted him instantly.
Yeah, it's called taking a chance.
Hey, question for you guys. What do you think about Boris Johnson?
Oh, I think he's a good guy.
Who?
Boris Johnson, the new Prime Minister.
I don't know anything about him, but I will look him up.
He looks like Trump. He looks like Trump. I was watching
a French TV station, and they show a lot of the British Parliament talking, and I've seen him. I got a few clips of him, but yeah, I don't think he's a bad guy at all.
Is he? What party? Conservative?
I forget what the...
Catherine, what party is he from?
Same
you know?
One as hers.
I have no idea, but I just think he's...
Same one as hers, but only she was a liberal.
So how can you be? I don't know. I never could understand.
It's
British
not
politics.
The conservative party. I forget what.
But
it
the
is.
Harumps and all that shit.
That's where we get our law from.
I
was
know.
England.
I know, but we don't go to
like
it's different. They don't elect their prime minister. The people don't.
Yeah, no shit, man.
Hey, what's he a sign?
Yeah.
Well, same as a lot of things we have.
Whatever they call their Congress, House of Commons, or whatever.
Parliament.
They decide. You know, Parliament, thank you. They decide who the Prime Minister is.
Is it right that people should get to elect who the Prime Minister is?
Any of you guys understand the Brexit thing? What the story is? I mean,
yeah,
the daughter, the pound has gone down.
I can tell you exactly what
has
Brexit
gone down?
Is. If Brexit is Britain leaving the European Union, right? So their fortunes, either good or bad, are on them. They're not tied to the economies of other countries that now they say, like, all right, Greece, for an example. Greece is a failing nation.
Right.
It's failing.
They want England to pay for it.
Now Britain's obligated to pay them for their mistakes. And Britain has no input into their government.
And Greece gets away with it, everybody be doing it.
Everyone's going to say, fuck it. Yeah, Germany and England will bail us out.
Right.
No. That's never going to happen. Because it's like, no.
They already
it's
did.
Yeah,
Greece has already happened.
Greece has already been bailed out, so as in Spain.
Right, another one. That's next on the list.
No, Spain's already gotten it. Because they went to an all-green policy and fucking electricity prices and shit shot through the fucking roof. Unemployment went up to 22% or something like that. I bet you it's still at least 20.
This is what the new Green Deal that over here in America they're trying to push.
Yeah, and you know what's funny?
Thing.
Right? People go, oh, you know what's 20% unemployment? Do you know what Oz is?
That's why Ocasio is considered a rising star for the Democrats. It's because of that new Green Deal.
Wait a minute. That's trying to confuse me or something. It's like, I don't understand the Brexit thing. I mean, they want out. I mean, and then want out, and what happens? I mean, the dollar's more worth more now than the pound is, I guess.
You know, Britain was never totally in the fucking European Union because they didn't go to the euro.
Monetary,
that's right. They never switched to the euro.
That's why they're the first to get out.
We're euro in Ireland. We're euro now.
You might be, but Britain isn't. England isn't. They're on pound sterling.
That's a pound. That's a pound. Yeah, it used to be pound. Before I left Ireland, it was a pound. And I come home and like, it's a euro. I'm like, what the hell are you guys talking about?
Catherine can't figure out the currency in her own country. It takes a while. Fuck, man, I'm used to dollars.
Well, that's like the Canadian money we get.
Yeah, we take Canadian money and basically burn it.
Well, we treat it as the same amount as America.
It's not!
Well, who looks out the pennies and tries to take them out?
I would fucking take a fucking Canadian penny and fucking push it into somebody's forehead.
No, I'm saying, but they just don't. All that just gets through. They change it into pennies and it's
gone. Yeah, but you never see Canadian currency, actual fucking paper currency. You see, very seldom do you even see Canadian coins anymore.
Right.
Come to tell you the truth. Nobody fucking wants Canadian money. It's like fucking Monopoly money. It's fucking useless.
I definitely don't want it. Machine at work rejects it.
Yeah, no shit, right? Yeah. It's the boss.
The weight.
What was this?
Fucking A.
The machine at work rejects Canadian money. I definitely don't want it.
Well, Canadian money's like plastic now.
Because of the weight.
Oh, that's another thing I wanted to ask you, Catherine. Are euros, the bills, are they plastic or are they paper?
All right,
what's so funny? Is it paper or plastic?
It's a stupid question, because it's obviously paper.
What?
I didn't catch that, Catherine.
It's a stupid question because it's obviously paper.
You asked me that question. It's obviously it's paper.
Oh, okay, because a lot of countries are switching over to plastic.
They last longer.
Yeah, plastic currency. Japan does it. What are the
It
European
costs them a lot of money to keep making money.
Yeah. Well, plus paper holds germs and stuff with plastic because it's non-porous.
Until they start trying to use digital currencies.
And do you know what the worst part about plastic money is? You can't roll it up and snort a line.
You can't bend it in half.
Oh, are you kidding me? Just said that?
Yep.
Yes, he did.
It'll be flexible.
Well, yeah, but it depends on how flexible it is.
You know
that's
what I mean?
True.
Real hard plastic.
And then you just wipe it off, and if the cops fucking pull up, it's like, dude, fucking.
Well, lick it off. Here, you want to sniff?
Oh, my Lord, you guys.
Cubs like, do you know why I pulled you over?
Yeah.
No.
Was I weaving in the lane trying to snow a line?
No, you were doing 6 miles an hour and fucking looking through your rearview mirror.
But no, is that crazy? No, I'm going back to immigration right now, to be honest with you, because I think it's ridiculous. I mean, when you marry somebody in America and they don't make it legal, your life's a mess, man. My life is a mess.
Well, Kevin, believe me, I agree the immigration system's broke.
You can't just fly over here for like a vacation
or
something?
I said that!
They won't do it?
I said, do you have a passport? Do you have a passport, Catherine?
Of course I have a passport.
Well, then fly over to America and see your kids.
I don't know would that go true or not, because I said I was only there for a vacation.
Well, give it a try.
For 6 months, then I married my dumbass motherfucking husband and had 2 kids with him, and he never...
Memories.
My mom, listen to me. Hey,
Kevin, look, I'm not trying to be rude or anything, but if you don't fucking try, how do you know?
I'm always scared.
Of what?
Because
they'll say no. That's the worst outcome you get. They say no.
That's what's going to happen. And then I don't want to hear
You don't know that for sure.
Afraid of rejection?
No, no, no. But you know what? This
I'll marry her and then sign up for work.
You can't apply
for I'm single again.
10 years.
Will you please stop up. Hitting on my friend,
no,
guys?
I'm not trying to hit on her. I'm just trying to... I'm serious. I'm a eunuch or whatever the fuck you want to call it.
A eunuch?
A eunuch?
Yeah.
Where the fuck is he from?
I'm going to take a guess on this, Jim. Is it because of the medications you're on? You just don't have a sex drive?
I don't have a sex drive. I was saying I'd marry you because, like I said, I'm single again, so I could marry you if you wanted to become a citizen.
You're single again, so you have to have another relationship, son.
Yeah, Jimmy, you don't make enough money. You'd never be able to sponsor it because you don't make enough money.
No shit, man.
I do.
It's called the bucks. It's called the dollar.
They want a guarantee of a certain amount of money in the bank and shit like that. Well, her son's a chef, Jim, all right? And he can't fucking afford to fucking sponsor her.
Chefs don't get much money.
How much would it cost to sponsor her?
Boston, Jimmy.
He's not a chef
at fucking McDonald's.
He'd get more money.
How much would it cost to sponsor?
He wasn't making enough money, so... Jimmy.
Catherine, how much would it cost to sponsor you to come here?
No idea.
Well, could you do me a favor? Could you find out?
No, it costs so much money. Sponsor thing is not. It's like.
You have any gay man? She gave her 26 years. She's back home.
No, she wants to come back because her kids are here.
Yeah.
I'm trying to help, but I want to do it legally.
Do they come over to you?
No, they haven't actually. Patrick just. I don't understand why he bought a car. He just bought a car. And he says, oh, I'm saving up to come home to see you. And I, you know the poor kid?
Well, it's
terrible.
It's not cheap to travel back and forth to Ireland.
Yeah, I know.
I can imagine what
it's than a rover. That was like
what's
500.
Catherine, what's a one-way ticket to Ireland, roughly?
Oh, it depends on the time of the year. I don't know what it is now.
Okay,
it depends
on
coming up like Christmas, it's going to be more expensive.
Yeah.
What's the cheapest?
You go, like, January
there you go.
Or
what would
like that.
What would be the cheapest you could fly if you had to guess?
I've had to guess. It probably would be, geez, you know, Paul, I'm not too sure.
500? You know, 1,000?
Probably 500, to be honest with you.
How much?
3,500.
That'd be about 500.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, that's not too bad.
No, 500.
That's not bad.
No, I can't wait to go there then. But I can't get...
Is that round trip or one way?
Oh, that'd be one way, my dear.
Yeah, it'd be 1,000 both ways. Jeremy, do you got a passport?
No.
Me neither. I've never had a passport.
Mine expired.
You don't,
I probably have enough money in the bank to sponsor her.
In America, you guys don't fly anywhere.
We don't need to. Everything's here.
Oh, shit. Look what I'm losing.
I do want to see the Grand Canyon. I haven't been to the Grand Canyon.
You
hear me?
I didn't take the Southern Road, so I never saw it. Mm. I did the Rocky.
I've been to Texas.
What the call?
You hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Oh, Texas?
I said I probably have enough money in the bank to sponsor her.
Yep. Jeremy's willing to sponsor you, Catherine.
Yeah, but he's got to marry you, too, with the save up, with the money.
Yeah.
That accent, I would do it.
That's never going to happen again. Let me tell you that one.
You do know I'm going to send this fucking show to your girlfriend, Jeremy.
I appreciate that.
Oh! Oh, I still love that one.
Do me a favor.
I don't have her as a friend on Facebook, but she does pop up occasionally as someone you might know. Oh, shit.
No, keep talking. I didn't get the show yet.
All right. But I also, I want to do a couple things here, Catherine. So we're over time. I want to do a shout out to the troops. For the troops serving overseas here in the States, and our veterans. And Glenn Spillman, Sports Insider, will be up next.
I was young, I was foolish, I was angry, I was fun, I was charming, I was lucky. Tell me how.